You're not no champ. Look at you, you're losing. You lost 3 rounds already. Come on, man. I'll hit you 4 times. It's worse, a man.
Muhammad said, never feel sorry for me. He said, I'm great. But, you know, maybe he may not feel bad, but the guy that fought him do, because you see what he's going through.
He put it on the line, brother. The representation that he gave to the black community will never be forgotten, no matter what.
I am the greatest.
It's just sad because, you know, it's sad because, you know, he's a great guy and hoping that maybe he could, like, live the kind of life that we live, you know. I'd love to see him do that, you know, because he earned that.
Last time I saw him, he was sitting down at a table drawing pictures. I walked up to him. I said, Ali, let's do it again. He said that for a moment. Then he slowly turned to me. And his eyes opened up, and he said, Norton.
Here, it was a fundraiser. It was for Parkinson's disease, and they were taking pictures for different newspapers and magazines, and McLean's magazine took a picture of Ali touching my hair and him saying to me, hey man, you got some pretty hair.
Well, I last saw him, he was out walking, and I was just elated. I would like to see him well, Ali, for the rest of his days here. I would just hope that that happens.
He had a big heart, good chin, fast feet, fast hands. What more would you want? You can't get anything else.
I love Ali like a brother and like a guy that is a celebrity and like a guy who's done a lot for a lot of people. Ali was one of those guys that made you feel good about yourself. You make everybody feel good, you know, everybody.
I look at Muhammad Ali today, especially, and I see a hero. Forget about some minority and all of that. This man was a hero to the world. And heroes, doesn't matter if they lost an arm or leg, they're still beautiful because of what they've done.
When I see him, he's love. Ali was all about love, man. You know what I mean? Like I say, he can't speak for himself, but we can speak for him.